program which is programmed for success, programmed for happiness, wants more happiness. And somebody told him very beautifully that you take a spiritual path, you will become very happy. So now this program has started executing that also. Only thing is that is a self-destruct program at that point. So this machine is programmed for success. This machine is programmed for happiness. You have to be successful, and they'll tell you what makes you success, what success brings success, brings happiness. That's what you are taught. Success means getting good marks, success means achieving something in life, and that means happiness. So success is equal to happiness. Okay, so now you are made to biased program. Biased towards achievement. Of course, achievement is required, because you don't want a washing machine which doesn't wash. You don't want a fan which doesn't work as a fan. So you are made into a slave of the society. That's what you are. So now there are teachings in society available for this guy who is suffering. A conceptual entity. Yeah, you go for a spiritual path, then you become free. Now that's also a program. But only thing is that program is a self-destructive program. It's destroying this guy who is running this program. You'll find out the real I, then this guy realizes that I'm not the I. Right? So as a part of the program, all people have come here. Okay. So what happening is, now let us take the other part also. There is the input which is received from the world. So you receive the input from the sense organs. It gets recorded as images, and it's recorded as a memory, words, languages. Now this machine is driving your whole life. Now who is doing? I am not doing. I am only powering this. I am giving power to this. I means consciousness is powering this, but I am not doing anything. Who is the doer? There's a reaction, continuous reaction is happening. So can you break this reaction cycle? Can you stop at this moment and say, yeah, I take the decision, I am the consciousness, I take the decision. Then you are breaking the cycle. So this decision is based on the pleasure and pain, award and reward. So you break this. No, this is what I want to take. Then you are coming from reaction cycle to action cycle. Then you are in charge of your life. Otherwise, you are not in charge of your life. Society is in charge of life. Whole environment is in charge of life.
But mind does not allow to take action like that.
Yeah, until you come to this class. You realize that mind says, I am the boss. Right? So, now let us take the other thing. Right? There is a seer, seen, and seeing. Seer and seeing is not there, only seeing is there. Okay? Doer and being done, doer and the action, result is not there, only doing is there. There's no doer. The doer is a memory. Okay? And that's not you. You are not there in that. Never there in that. Right? So who meditates? Who
meditates? Program. It goes into that.
The whole purpose of meditation is to pause the program. Pause the program by the program.
She's saying, what is that supposed to be?
So the mind has to be made silent. Mind is not you. Mind is not you. Mind is your instrument. Right? Now instrument has become the master. Says, I am the master. Right? So, pause. I am the master. I am consciousness.
It's like asking the working genie to go around the tree.
Working?
There's a story that there's a working genie which keeps coming back and saying, now what to do?
What to do?
finally say, okay, go around the tree and go
to the tree. Okay. So, is this clear? Now, your entire memory structure is based on the world. Okay? Let me ask you now one question. Is there a world out there? It doesn't look like. World doesn't exist. But existence is there. Okay? World is pursued through sense organs. Sense organs are very limited in nature. It's like five blind men trying to figure out what elephant is. Can you find out with this limited sense organs what is there out there? This five blind men story I have told you? What is out there, these limited senses cannot find out. Ears are limited, eyes are limited, and also these are like five blind men. They fight with each other. Eyes will say only the out there is form. Ear will say no, only out there is sound. Okay? Tongue will say, no, what is out there is taste. So these five blind men are giving input. So the mind has to make a picture of what is out there. Okay? The picture of what is out there, the picture made by the mind is called world. That's also not real.
It is partially real.
No, I'm saying, when I say not real, it doesn't mean that it is not useful. It is useful. But it's not real. It's a representation. It is useful for you to this vehicle to navigate and all. It's a map. But that's not what out there.
What we are perceiving is basically limited, very few, 1%
of. Not even 1%. Right? What is out there? Only thing we can say what is out there is the sun exists. The moon exists. The tree exists, okay? The river exists. Existence is there, we can say. And what is seen is conditioned by the sense organs. That we cannot say anything about it. Okay? Suppose I give you a goggle, which is special goggle, it's X-ray vision. Then what, if you see me, what do you see?
You see the bones.
You see the bones. The handsome Prabhu is gone now.
Skeleton is there.
Some ghost is sitting there. So it all depends on what is your sense organs. They are very limited. With this limited, you are trying to see the unlimited, which is existence. So whatever you are seeing is also not real. The seer is not real. Okay? Then you are crying, I'm suffering in my life. That's also not real. It is real to the extent of it's a sort of a representation. I mean, the best I can say is it's like a virtual reality. Reality is watching, virtual reality is playing out. Right?
You are still agreeing that there is a sun and moon.
No.
You said sun exists, moon.
I am saying I am only agreeing to the part existence. What so exists there, I don't know. I can never find out. The sun, the word sun used is one part in the head here. This is called sun. There's a program. Object. Okay, what is out there, you don't know. What is in here is a memory. Who is watching is consciousness, which is you, which you will never find out. Allah, nim kothi lani ide antu guttare. I exist antu guttane. Adikken madakala. Adi ashte. Nim bereyan confuse madkondi adarthike bolste. Naan deha, naan manasu buddhi, I am the body, I am mind, the intellect, I am husband, I am wife. All this confusion is causing suffering. But for not for you, that's the point. For really there is no suffering. For changing you, there is a suffering. And changing you is, by program, it is made to suffer. The program of changing I.
Why? Why only suffer?
Otherwise, you don't do the work, no. A donkey requires stick and carrot. If you only like the changing you, Gayatri, is always happy, who will do any work? Who will come to this class? The world to run, you have to give pain and pleasure. That is by design, that program is like that. The reward and punishment. And that reward and punishment is also part of karma. You are supposed to work, that's all. So, with this understanding, is there any change happening in life? Where you look at life? And sir, Nagesh?
Balanced mind, maybe.
Mind can be balanced, is it?
No, means take everything.
Take your equanimity.
Yeah.
So, don't try to gain anything in meditation, nothing you can gain. So,
You
just understand. You understand the reality and sit. So, why meditation one? No, nobody became enlightened one day.
But Guruji, one question is, do you have to silence the, ordinarily, do you have to silence the mind?
No. Not at all. You have to understand the falsehood of the mind. Okay. But you have to sit silently and observe the mind, just to see, because the mind will come subtle and subtle aspect of mind will open up. So when you say, when you don't sit and observe the mind, the grosser aspect of the mind you can come in the normal day to day, but subtle aspect of mind will open up. So it was watched. Without getting involved. That's called Sakshi. That's called real meditation. Nothing else is meditation.
Subtle aspect of mind means any example.
One day mind will say, what is this all nonsense? I am enlightened. That ego has become very subtle. Now it's taken the shape. Earlier it was taking as a mother employee. Now it has taken the shape. I am the enlightened one. You see, all the people in the world are useless people. I am only spiritual. The ego takes spiritual form. So then it creates impressions. Then you say, that it will say, whatever I am doing is right only, because I am spiritual. So that I am has not gone.
So that is you sitting and observing the subtler aspect,
which is? It will open up. What is the problem? The key why it opens up, I will tell you. He told about genie, right? What genie is that? There is a genie. One day Allahuddin got a genie. The genie's job is, what is that? Doing genie.
Doing work.
Working genie. Genie. Whatever you tell it to do, immediately do a comeback.
Yes.
Okay? So now this genie, this guy is fed up. Every moment before he says, he completes and comes back. Then what to do with genie? He said, go, keep going around the tree. So he's stuck there. So like that, you give a job for the mind to keep going around the main gate. So, when he'll meditating, it'll get frustrated. Then it'll come back and say,
out of meditation, frustration.
Yeah, everything. No. Meditation means what? Not doing anything. No. Meditation means what? Not doing anything. So it'll get frustrated. Right? So it'll say, what do you think I am? I'm already enlightened. Why are all these things? These are not required for me. It'll come out. Then you say, watch. And go around again. Go around the tree. So like that, all the tricks of the mind will open up when you sit silently. Because mind cannot tolerate sitting silent, idle. It is programmed for becoming. I have to become something. You say, be sit. Then you come back with another excuse. Leg pain. There's no pain actually. You say. Then we'll come back and, oh, if I sit like this, when will this thing, household work will do? My husband never does, I know. He'll say. So again you get up. So again the mind will keep, mind wants to do something, keeps on doing. That's designed for that.
By default.
Sit. Okay. Are you clear? Any questions? So now he'll sit for some time.